I welcome you all to my YouTube channel Insight into Chemical Engineering. In this lecture series, we will solve the unsolved problem of a famous book, Stoichiometry and Process Calculations by K.V. Narayanan. These lectures are helpful for chemical engineering students because process calculations is a core subject for chemical engineering branch. So during lecture, step-by-step solution will be provided. And in this lecture, exercise number 3.78 to 3.82 will be covered. Please like and subscribe for motivation. Problem number 3.78, the following reaction occurs in a mixture consisting of 2 moles of methane, 1 mole water, 1 mole CO2 and 4 mole hydrogen initially. Find out the mole fraction of hydrogen in term of extent of reaction. So we can assume epsilon is the extent of reaction, and then we can find out the moles of reactant and product as the reaction progresses. So suppose epsilon is the extent of reaction, so rewrite the balanced chemical reaction and write the number of moles of reactant and product which are present at time t equal to 0. Now we have assumed epsilon is the extent of reaction, so we can write at time t moles of CH4 will be equal to 2 minus epsilon, and for H2O it will be 1 minus epsilon, and for CO it will be 1 plus epsilon, for H2 it will be 4 plus 3 epsilon. Now we can find out the total moles at time t. So total moles will be equal to summation of moles of product and reactant at time t. So it will come out as 8.2 epsilon. Now we need to find the mole fraction of hydrogen. So mole fraction of hydrogen will be equal to moles of hydrogen present at time t divided by total moles present at time t. Now problem number 3.79, a system consisting of 2 moles methane and 3 mole water is undergoing the following reaction. So in this case, 2 reactions are given, and we need to find out mole fraction of hydrogen in term of extent of reactions. So what we can do, we can assume the separate extent of reaction for each reaction. Suppose epsilon 1 and epsilon 2 are the extent of reactions. Now the initial moles of methane and water are given, so we can write the moles of reactant and product at time t. So at time t, moles of CH4 will be equal to initial moles, that is 2 minus epsilon. So epsilon will be corresponding to first reaction, and epsilon 2 will be corresponding to second reaction, because CH4 is taking part in both reactions. So number of moles of H2O will be equal to initial moles of H2O, that is 3 minus epsilon 1 minus 2 epsilon 2, because the stoichiometric coefficient is 2 in second reaction. Now we can write the number of moles of CO. So CO is produced only in reaction 1. So number of moles of CO will be equal to epsilon 1. And number of moles of CO2 will be equal to epsilon 2, because CO2 is produced only in second reaction. So we can write the number of moles of H2. So it will come out from first reaction, that is 3 epsilon 1, and from second reaction, that is 4 epsilon 2. Now we can estimate the total number of moles at time t. It will be equal to summation of all these number of moles. Now, mole fraction of H2 can be estimated, and it will be equal to moles of H2 at time t divided by total moles. Problem number 3.80. The following gas phase reaction occur in a mixture initially containing 3 moles ethylene, 2 mole oxygen. Derive an expression for mole fraction of ethylene in term of extent of reaction. So again, two chemical reaction are given, so we can assume epsilon 1 is the extent of reaction for first reaction and epsilon 2 is the extent of reaction for second reaction. Then we can find out the number of moles of reactant and product at time t. So at time t, number of moles of C2H4 will be equal to initial moles minus epsilon 1, it will come out from reaction 1, and minus epsilon 2, it will come out from reaction 2nd. And number of moles of N2 will be equal to initial moles minus epsilon 1 divided by 2 minus 3 epsilon 2. And number of moles of CH2 twice 2O will be equal to epsilon 1 because it is produced only in reaction 1. Now, in the same way, we can find out the number of moles of CO2, and it will be equal to 2 epsilon 2 because CO2 is only coming in second reaction and the stoichiometric coefficient of CO2 is 2. And number of moles of H2O will be equal to 2 epsilon 2. Now we can find out the total number of moles, which will be equal to summation of all these number of moles. Now, mole fraction of ethylene will be equal to moles of ethylene at that time divided by total moles. Problem number 3.81. In the vapor phase, hydration of ethylene to ethanol and diethyl ether is obtained as a byproduct. So first reaction is desired reaction, second one is undesired reaction. Feed mixture consisting of ethylene inert and water. So percentage of reactants are given, and the product analyzed, certain percentage ethylene, ethanol, ether and water and inerts. And composition of product is also given, and we need to estimate the conversion of ethylene, yield of ethanol and ether based on ethylene. So in this case, compositions of feed and products are given. So initially we can assume the total moles of feed equal to 100, and corresponding to that we can estimate the feed composition as well as product compositions. So we will assume the total moles of reactant feed to the reactor is 100 moles. So this 100 moles contains 55% ethylene, 5% inerts and 40% water. So moles of ethylene will be equal to 55 mole, moles of H2O will be 40 moles, and moles of inert will be 5 mole. So here inerts is the tie component because number of moles of inerts will not change during the operation. So number of moles of inerts in the feed composition will be equal to number of moles of inerts in the product. Now total moles of products are not known, so we can assume the total moles of product is equal to some number. So assume it's a P. So total moles of product equal to P. Now this P contains 52.26% ethylene and 5.49% ethanol, 0.16% ether and 36.81 water, and rest is inerts. So we can estimate the compositions of C2H4. It will be equal to 52.26% of P, and moles of water will be equal to 36.8% of P, and moles of inert will be 5.28% of P. So in the same way, we can write the number of moles of ethanol and ether in the products. Now, number of moles of inerts in product and number of moles of inert in feed will remain same. So we can equate and we can estimate the value of P. So value of P will come out as 94.70. Now we can put the value of P and we can estimate the product compositions. So we can write the moles of C2H4 unreacted in the product equal to 49.49, and moles of H2O will be equal to 37.88, and moles of inerts equal to 5, and moles of ethanol and ether can also be written. So total moles of C2H4 reacted will be equal to moles of C2H4 fed to the reactor, that is 55 mole. So 55 moles of C2H4 fed to the reactor, and moles of C2H4 coming out in the product is 49.49. That means these moles are unreacted. So total moles of C2H4 reacted will be equal to initial moles minus unreacted moles. So only 5.51 moles of C2H4 got reacted. Now moles of C2H4 converted to ethanol. So how many moles of C2H4 got converted to ethanol? So amount of ethanol produced is 5.2 mole, and from reaction 1 we can say that 1 mole of C2H5OH will be produced from 1 mole of C2H4. So moles of C2H5O4 produced is 5.2 mole. So corresponding to that, 5.2 mole of C2H4 will be required. That means 5.2 moles of C2H4 converted to ethanol. Now we can also find out the moles of C2H4 converted to ether. Moles of ether in the product is 0.15, and from second reaction 1 mole of ether is produced out of 2 moles of C2H4. So 0.15 mole of ether will be produced out of 2 into 0.15 equal to 0.3 moles of C2H4. Now we can write the percentage conversion of C2H4, which will be equal to moles of C2H4 reacted divided by total moles of C2H4 fed to the reactor into 100. So moles of C2H4 reacted and fed to the reactors are already estimated in previous slide. So percentage conversion will come out as 10%. Now percentage yield of ethanol will be equal to moles of reactant converted to desired product. So here desired product is ethanol. So how many moles of C2H4 got converted to ethanol divided by total moles of reactant converted? Because here we have two reactions, so certain moles of C2H4 will go to the desired reaction and certain moles will go to the undesired reaction. So percentage yield of ethanol will come out as 94.37%. Now in the same way we can estimate the percentage yield of ether. So for percentage yield of ether, moles of reactant, that is C2H4, converted to desired product. So here we will take moles of C2H4 converted to ether divided by total moles of C2H4 converted. Problem number 3.82, elemental phosphorus is produced from phosphate rock in an electric furnace by the following reaction. The furnace is fed with 1000 kg phosphate. So initial amount of phosphate is given and carbon charged is 25% in excess. So amount of carbon which is charged is 25% in excess and silica charged is 50% excess. So in this chemical reaction, carbon and SiO2 are charged in excess and amount of phosphate charged is 1000 kg. And it is also given reaction goes to 95% completion. The unconverted reactants along with calcium silicate formed constitutes the slag. Calculate the following: the mass of carbon and silica charged and the amount of phosphorus obtained and mass of slag produced. So in part A, we need to find out the mass of carbon and silica charged. So weight of phosphate is given, which is equal to 1000 kg. Now we can estimate the number of moles of phosphate because molecular weight of phosphate is 310 g/mol. So number of moles of phosphate will be equal to weight divided by its molecular weight. So it will come out as 3.22 kmol. Now rewrite the balanced chemical reaction. Now 2 moles of phosphate combines with 10 moles of carbon and 6 moles of silicon oxide. So available moles of phosphate is 3.22 kmol. So 1 mole will combine with less, so it will be equal to 10/2, and 3.22 moles will combine with 16.1 kmol of carbon. Now we can estimate the weight of carbon and it will be equal to moles of carbon into its molecular weight. So it will come out as 193.2 kg. Now as per problem, carbon charged is 25% in excess. So we can estimate the amount of carbon in excess. So weight of carbon in excess will be equal to 25% of 193.2 kg. That is the theoretically required amount as per 3.22 kmol of phosphate. So weight of carbon in excess will come out as 48.3 kg. So total carbon charged will be equal to theoretically amount plus excess amount. So it will be equal to 241.5 kg. Now again rewrite the balanced chemical reaction, and from this chemical reaction we can say that 2 moles of phosphate combines with 6 moles of silicon oxide. So 1 mole will combine with 6 by 2 moles of silicon oxide, and available moles of phosphate is 3.22 kmol. So 3.22 kmol will combine with 9.66 kmols of SiO2. Now we can estimate the weight of SiO2, and it will be equal to moles of SiO2 into its molecular weight. So it will come out as 579.6 kg. Now as per problem, it is given SiO2 charged is 50% in excess. So we need to find the excess amount of SiO2, and that will be equal to 50% of 579.6 kg. So excess amount of SiO2 will be equal to 289.8 kg. So total amount of SiO2 charged will be equal to theoretical amount of SiO2 plus excess amount. So it will come out as 869.4 kg. Now for part B, again rewrite the moles of phosphate, that is equal to 3.22 kmol. Now it is given reaction is 95% completed. So accordingly we can estimate the moles of phosphate which are converted to the product. So moles of phosphate reacted will be equal to 95% of 3.22 kmol. So only 3.059 kmols of phosphate got reacted. Now 2 moles of calcium phosphate produces with 1 mole of P4. So from this chemical reaction we can say that 2 moles of calcium phosphate produces 1 mole of phosphorus. So 3.059 kmol of phosphate will produce 1.53 kmol of P4. So we can find the weight of P4, because moles of P4 is 1.53 kmol and molecular weight of P4 is 124. So weight of P4 will be equal to moles of phosphorus into its molecular weight, and it will come out as 189.66 kg. Now part C. In part C, the slag consists of unreacted reactants and calcium silicate. So we need to find the composition of unreacted reactants and calcium silicates. So again rewrite the chemical reaction and express this reaction in term of molar mass. Now weight of phosphate reacted is equal to 1000 into 0.95, and it will be equal to 950 kg, because amount of phosphate is given, that is equal to 1000 kg, and 1000 kg is charged, and as per problem it is given the conversion is only 95%. So out of 1000 kg only 950 kg of phosphate will take part in the chemical reaction, and rest will go in the product as unconverted. So unconverted weight will be equal to 50 kg. Now from this chemical reaction we can say that 620 gram of phosphate reacts with 120 gram of carbon. So 1 gram will react with less, so it will be equal to 120 divided by 620, and the amount of phosphate is 950 kg. So 950 kg will react with 183.87 kg of carbon. Now from part B, total carbon charged we have already estimated, and that is equal to 241.5 kg. So unreacted amount of carbon will be equal to the total amount charged minus reacted amount. So reacted amount we have estimated, that is equal to 183.87 kg. So it will come out as 57.63 kg. Now again we can rewrite 620 gram of phosphate reacts with 360 gram of SiO2. So from this chemical reaction, 620 gram of phosphate will react with 360 gram of SiO2. So 1 gram will react with less amount, and the available amount of phosphate is 950. So it will combine with 551.61 kg. Now again from part B, total SiO2 charged is 869.4 kg. So we can estimate the unreacted amount of SiO2, and it will be equal to the total amount of SiO2 charged minus reacted amount. So it will give unreacted amount of SiO2. Now we need to estimate the amount of calcium silicate. So 120 gram of phosphate can produce 696 gram of calcium silicate. So 1 gram will produce less, and the available amount of phosphate charged is 950 kg. So amount of calcium silicate produced will be equal to 1066.45 kg. So we can write the weight of slag. So total weight of slag will be equal to unreacted reactants plus calcium silicate. So it will come out as 1491.87 kg. Thank you.